Hello everyone, welcome to the stream with me. My name is George. You can find me as Volquero in various different forums for Amiga. After a small break, I am back to stream about AmigaOS, AmigaOS 4 this time. Welcome everyone to the stream. Hello SLD Snake, welcome to the stream, glad you are here. Today we are going to see again things about AmigaOS 4, and we will focus on applications that have to do with music and creating music. Although I'm not a music composer, I'm not a musician, but I'll do my best to present you with all the available applications that you can use on AmigaOS 4. Some of them are coming from AmigaOS 3, so they are available there as well. And we run the 68K code. And but some of them are native for AmigaOS 4 and they are running on the PowerPC CPU. And also we will see a preview, we will have a preview of a brand new application that is going to be released pretty soon, and this is called Rave. But before all this, let me stop first of all the music here, so that we can talk about music, right? Before we start talking about music applications and the topic that I want to present you today, I'm going to show you a little bit more about the AmigaOS 4 as an operating system and its file system. On the previous streams we have seen all the folders that come with AmigaOS 4 and what's the purpose of each and every one of them, but we missed only one, which actually it's not a folder that you can see in the file system. You can't find it here anywhere, because this is something that exists on environment. And the name of this assigned mostly is APPDIR, and this is quite useful for AmigaOS 4, and actually it is something that you won't find on the other Amiga flavor operating systems. APPDIR, if we go here and open a terminal and write APPDIR like that, you see that something exists. It's not a folder, it's an assign. And if we do list, it takes a few seconds, but you see hundreds of applications. APPDIR, the purpose for APPDIR is something like a way to find any application that is installed and the user uses on his AmigaOS 4 machine. For example, if I do something like APPDIR Amiga Amp 3, it will start. Let me drag it here. It will start the Amiga Amp 3. If I do something like APPDIR format, okay, it misses an argument, so it found it. Let me do something else, input maybe. It starts input. So you don't have to remember where exactly this application is installed. You can use APPDIR to run any application on your machine. For example, if I do APPDIR Emotion, it will start the application. How it works? APPDIR is a handler that you can find under L. Here, there is a handler. And also under devs, DOS drivers, there is a file that starts this handler. Hello Aris Amiga, welcome to the stream. So if we see here, it mounts it's a mount list that mounts the APPDIR, and if we check it here, you see that it uses the APPDIR handler. The way that it works is that it creates, let's say, an assign on environment. So if we go on environ, so if we go environ APPDIR, you will see that's the path, and if we do list, the files are there. Actually, there are no files there. There are links of the executable files into that folder. So whenever you try to go and run an application, it creates that link, that software link, from the executable, wherever it is, into that folder. For example, let me remove the Amiga app. So if I go right now, let's say, to RAM and do APPDIR Amiga app 3, okay, it finds it because probably it is on env. Remember, the environ is copied whenever you use something from the environ, is copied to the env folder. So if we do the same, delete environ APPDIR / Amiga app 3, okay, and if we do that on environment as well, so logically, if I run right now Amiga app, okay, it still finds it. Yeah, probably because I ran it earlier. Let me have a look. List APPDIR Amiga app. Okay, so we have two files there, Amiga app 3 and Amiga app prefs. So if I do APPDIR Amiga app 3 and try to run the application, what the hell? Actually, it shouldn't find it. Maybe because I didn't actually delete it. Let me see. Delete force. Because it is a link, so I have to be sure that it is deleted. Yes. Let me try that now. Yeah. So Amiga amp still starts. So, to make it clear, APPDIR is something like, you can have it in your mind like a base place where you can find any application that you run on your machine. Let me show you something else. If I go to, if I do list APPDIR M player, you will see here that I have M player that points to this folder. Okay, let me open another terminal and go to SDH3, where it is here, video, and do a list here. And you will see that I have the MIG JT M player like that, but also I have another M player, which is the Live for It M player NG. Okay, so if I go into that Live for it, mplayer.ng, and do a list here, you will see that I have an application that calls mplayer. Let me run it like that. Okay, so we run it, the leave for it and player, and let me execute here again the list APPDIR. You will see that the same mPlayer changed the place where it points and finds that executable, because both of these versions of mPlayer have the same the exact same name. So if you run the same, let's say, application from another place, then APPDIR changes automatically the where he can find that application. For example, if I go here, let me do that again with AmigaAmp. You see here the AmigaAmp MP3 is in this path. If I go music and take the AmigaAmp and copy that here, for example, and run it from this place and do again the list, you will see that it changes from this path to this path here. So APPDIR is a very useful way to have everything that you use able to be found and execute the application. This can be used on scripts, this can be used on applications that, for example, the iBrowse or anything else that requests the path for the executable, for the binary. So you can put it there, APPDIR, colon, whatever you want. And this can be used also for finding if the user has that application available. The thing is that if I try right now that I deleted, let me see, yeah, now that I deleted the AmigaAmp from the this partition, this the APPDIR can't find it because the path that it knew doesn't exist anymore. So I have to go here and at least run it once, and then this is going to be available through APPDIR. Pretty useful characteristic that you can't find it in AmigaOS 3 or Morphos, and yeah, it is available. So if you don't know exactly where it is, the application, you can find it always on APPDIR. But for the APPDIR to have the link to the application, it has at least to the user has at least to run this application at least once. Hello, Livelord, welcome to the stream. Hello. So that's the APPDIR, and also if you go to the startup sequence and search here for APPDIR, you will see that there are a couple of lines that if that exists, it adds the APPDIR on the path. That means that wherever you are, if you type a command for the executable, the system is going to search into that path to find the executable. If this line is not available, so you have to be inside APPDIR to search for the applications that exist there. Pretty useful, and I used it on the scripts that I have for Media Vault, so that I don't know where exactly the user might have the Amiga app or the FF Play, and I use the APPDIR to find it and execute it and use it with Media Vault. So, as I said earlier, today we are going to play with applications that exist on AmigaOS 4 that work pretty well on AmigaOS 4 and has to have to do with the music and music creation. So let's see which applications I have here on my machine installed. As I said, I'm not a musician, okay, so I don't know how to create music, but let's see what we have. AmigaAmp, of course, it's an application you have seen that a lot of times for me to use it. It's only for listening to music. I will pass the Mod Explorer because it doesn't work for me quite well. And I will go to the Ahi record. This is an application, I think it is native, this version. I think it is native for AmigaOS 4. Here you can set the input device, and Ahi record, if you don't know that, is for recording sound from an outsource. You can record sound from the microphone or another input to the sound card that you might have. And you can save it in these formats, AIFF, WAVE, and FLAC. And then you can use it on other applications to create your song or whatever you want. Pretty nice application, but it has the... I don't know if it is a problem of Ahi Record or of Ahi in general. You can't run two times the Ahi Record and record two sources of sound at the same time. That would be really useful if you would like to do something like create podcasts on AmigaOS 4. If you could have an outsource that has music and you have your microphone, and you could at the same time record both of them and lower the level of the music source when you want to speak and things like that. Unfortunately, this is not possible to do with this application, and I don't know if it is if there is any other application out there that could do something like that. Hello, Evan Murphy, welcome to the stream. But it's a good application to record something from your microphone or another source through your sound card. Next one, I would like then to show you the tracker applications that we have. Let's go with the usage of the application. So let's see, the we have the Hively tracker. Let's see and load a mod. That's an application that, of course, you can create your mod files, okay, mod music. Let's see something else. And it supports also HBL mod files with more than four tracks at the same time, as you can see here. Next tracker application I can show you is the Milky tracker. Let me minimize that. Quite popular application among the musicians, of course. Let me load something. all these trackers are supporting different formats of mode files or tracker files. I don't know how they name those files, but have a different number of channels, and that's the way where you can write the music actually. Let me see if I have something else. Okay, that's Milky Tracker. Next one, we have Pro Tracker. So a lot of trackers in AmigaOS 4, and they all work quite well. Let me see how I can load something here. No. Most of these trackers, because they are coming, they are applications. Yeah, I have here the list, of course. They are applications that you can find on other operating systems as well. They are based mostly on SDL, and they are ported on AmigaOS 4. And the good thing is having these applications ported from other operating systems is that if you would like to work on your music on multiple systems, you are not blocked by doing that. If you have the same application on your AmigaOS 4 and then go to your PC and continue your work, it's exactly the same feeling and the same way to use them. For me, the most times I use those applications just for like players, because I don't have the ability to write any music. Okay, and yeah. So let me show you something else. And then I think we have. We have also Octament Sound Studio. This is a 68K application, quite popular. But to make that work in AmigaOS 4, you need to have the Maestrix. It's a driver that emulates a sound card that can be used from Octament Sound Studio. So the only thing that you need to do is to double click the Maestrix. This is running. If you go to the exchange, you will see it here. And then open the Octament Sound Studio, and from here open something like a mode, this one, and play it. I will open a different windows. Show you that they are working just fine. Let me open something else. that's Octament Sound Studio. And other than that, did I miss anyone from the trackers? No, I think that's all the trackers that I have tested and they are working fine. And then we have some applications that are used to edit sound. Okay, and I'm going to show you them right now. SLD Snake says that Maestrix is a little tricky, but it's a must-have for those kind of applications. Yeah, SLD Snake, you are right. This is the same way how you can run sound Octament Sound Studio on Morphos. The Maestrix was released a few days ago, actually, and exists on Morphos as well. And I think on Aros that you can use it as well. And the yeah, it has a lot of documentation to understand why this is needed. Yeah, I think it emulates the Maestro card, the Maestro, the Maestro Pro card, sound card, and uses Ahi also to output the music. Yep, a recent version, exactly, SLT Snake. I don't know, you used it under Amithlon, eh? I don't know if there are other applications that could benefit from this specific driver. If you know SLD Snake, please write on the chat. So what else you can do about sound, and that's more the area that I am dealing with sound mostly. There is AMI Sound Editor. This is, I believe it is a native application. Yes, it is a native application, AmigaOS 4 application. It's pretty simple. You can open any sound file that it supports, of course, not everything. Let me find something from an old project of mine. Let's try this one. It understands if the sound is, if the file is stereo or mono, and show you this waveform of the file, of the sound, and you can listen to it and go then and mark an area, and if you want, you can zoom into this area and listen to from here, and maybe you say that okay, I want to cut that part and remove it and do stuff like that. I use mostly this application for the ability to convert the sound to other formats. For example, you have all these options where you can take an a sound from MP3, for example, and convert it to AIFF, because this format is something that you can use in most of the applications for Amiga. And also, if you have a sound on MP3 or OGG that you want to use on a tracker application, because it is going to be the sound of your of your instrument, or a speech sound that you want to use on your song, you can do it with the AMI Sound Editor. And it's a pretty useful application. Continue, okay. And then there is also the, I will show you the HDREC a little bit later. There is also, which one? The sound effects, a 68K application that works pretty good on AmigaOS 4. Let me load something here. Parent. This application, there are different versions for AmigaOS, for 68K CPUs. You can use it on AmigaOS 3 as well, of course. And in AmigaOS 4, I found that it has a flaw with the MP3 files. Although that you can load an MP3 file once, if you try to load them again, the application crashes. Here you can do much more things than with the previous application. With the sound, of course, you can listen to it. And then it has a lot of ways to analyze the sound. For example, here you can do high detail analysis of the sound and see. The experts know much better than me what's the reason to do something like that. I believe you can see how good the sound is and sounds, of course. And of course you can cut parts of the sound and then create another music file and save it on your hard disk. I don't know if there is, let me see, I think that's, yeah, those are all the formats. Let me see if I can zoom. Those are all the formats that you can export the sound from sound effects. And actually sound effects is it was a commercial application, but there is you can find a key that was given, I think, from Amiga Future, the magazine, and you find that and you can use it full on your computer. Yes. And what you can do with all these sounds, there is also audio evolution. There are versions of audio evolution for 68K Amigas, for AmigaOS 3 to run it, and for Aeros, if I'm not wrong, and Morphos, and AmigaOS 4, the one that we run here. I use it, I like to use audio evolution because you have many different channels and you can add there all of your sounds and create a big music file or something else. I used it on when I was doing some podcasts. So I have here the sound of the intro. Let me start it. No, from here. And then you can go to another place and start the sound from there and add more sound files, and then create the end music, the end file, by exporting that to AIFF if you want, or I think you can do it MP3 from here. Save project. Let me see. No, you can save it as AIFF, and then use the AMI sound editor to convert it back to MP3 if you want. And of course here you can also cut parts of the sound, or set the volume of the sound. For example, here, let me show you. Here I have the intro, and then from one point I do a fade out and let the speech enter into the sound, and then at the end I do the opposite thing. I do a fade in of the outro and a fade out to close at the end of the podcast. And also you can have you can cut parts of the sound, or you can put some of the effects on the sound if you want. And from the bottom here you have the mixer. Of course, as I said, I'm not an expert, so an expert could do much more things than me. I just do it for simple stuff, and it's pretty good. Other than that, we have HD Rec. This is an awesome application. I think exists, I'm pretty sure it exists for AmigaOS 3 as well. Let me load, for example, this one. Let me start. That's an exceptional application. It was created on Blitz Basic 2, if I'm not wrong, and it's version 0.10 beta. Exceptional work, because you can go quite deep. This is an application that is used usually with MIDI keyboards or MIDI instruments, because you can configure, as much as I understand, exactly play on your keyboard and record that on your on here, and then set exactly what kind of instrument this is, and program that through your MIDI, and it has so many options to do stuff here, and also put some effects. So if you are here, you can listen on the score, and you can also, if you want, you can add here something. And that record here, and then repeat it if you want, and make it make an interesting music, something that I can do. This application has so many options, so much depth. It's exceptional work. Unfortunately, it's not maintained anymore, but it's pretty good. Yes, SL the Snake, as much as I know, it is 68K. This one, this version that I run, is native for OS 4, but there is a version for 68K as well. It's a very good application, and it's exceptional that it was created on plain Blitz Basic, right? Unfortunately, it's not maintained. What else I could show you? Then we can go to applications that you can use to rip music from CD-ROMs, for example. There is code audio. Actually, code audio, let me run it. And it crashed my system. Let me reboot and take a breath. SLD Snakes, I remember it has more than one binary for those different. Yes, yeah. Yeah, I wish the developer of this application could come back and continue that work. It's exceptional. Although, to be honest, I haven't seen many people, many musicians mentioning that application, and I don't know if they actually use it a lot or not. But yeah, I believe it has so much depth because you can go to the exact instrument and change things, and you can go only to a specific part and put some effects there. And also it is modular because you can add plugins to the output of the sound. So you can change the overall outcome of a specific instrument. But that's the things that I understand, right? I might miss a lot of the things there. So, code audio. Code audio is quite old application. Actually, it's not an application that does something on itself. It's a front end for other CLI applications like LAME or Encode or MP3 Encode and things like that. You can see them all here are the CLI applications that are supported. And the main job for the code audio is to convert files between formats, especially if you have a WAV file or IFF file and you want to make it an MP3. Or the opposite, or create them, convert them to OGG. And also it is quite useful because you can do that in batches. So you can create a list of files and say that, okay, I have those files and I want to convert them all to MP3s with these characteristics. I used that a lot, quite a lot time ago when I was creating from from audio CDs. I was creating my MP3 files to have them in my Amiga. But right now I don't do that because you can download the MP3 files straight away from the source. But most of the times the bands or the singers provide the MP3 files. Or something else in another format, but if you want to do that, code audio is quite useful because it has so many options that you can fine-tune exactly the output application. The output audio file. Another application that is very good for ripping audio from audio CD-ROMs is the Ad Ripper. Unfortunately, I don't have a CD-ROM on my X5000. SLD Snake says, based on LAME, so good encoder. Yeah, I remember using LAME to when we were downloading MP3 files that were 320 kbps and we wanted to play that on our Amiga 1200 on lower resolution so that it can actually play on the 020 or 030. And we had to convert it to IFF and then convert it back to MP3 or something like that. LAME, we were using LAME a lot back then. The Ad Reaper is developed by Daniel Gentlica. You might heard about Daniel on various. He's active on various Amiga forums with the nickname Trixie, and that's an application that you can use to rip music from your audio CD to MP3 files or OGG files. It's quite useful and easy to use because when you insert a CD-ROM or an audio CD on your CD-ROM, you see all the tracks as a list here, and you can select exactly which ones you would like to convert, and also you can set here the artist, the title of of each song, or you can import that information from an online service and get all the titles straight into your list, and then you can select how you can you would like the format of the exported audio. Those are the supported audio files. You can export it as MP3 files or OGG files or even FLAC if you don't want to waste the depth of the sound. And then with the click on a button, the Ad Reaper does all the work for you. The OS4 CD file system doesn't convert CDs to WAV on the fly. SLD Snake, I'm not sure. I don't know. You mean by taking the files from the audio CD and copy, drag and drop them into a folder, right? I'm not sure. I'm not sure if this is done. And that's the Ad Reaper and what you can do with that. This application is only available for AmigaOS 4, unfortunately. And then let's say that you created your audio CD and you have the files, the MP3 files in your computer. What you can do to manipulate your library, because you might have many CDs. There is iTunes available, which you can use to have a list. You can feed it with a folder where you have all your files. It scans that folder and finds all the files, and you can use it like a library where you can find the audio, the audio files, and search about something specific. For example, if I write rock, you can find Amiga Rocks, this album here, and then you can say, okay, let's select these files and say play that, and it starts Amiga amp, and also it has the album cover at the bottom. So if you have different files from different albums, you can see also your album here. And also it's very interesting because what you can do is you can create a playlist from this application, so you can save them. Let's say if I go here on playlist window, I can select a few of them and add to list. Sorry. Playlist, add to the playlist. So you have here your playlist, which you can then save as MP3U or PLS, whatever you want, and use them on your audio player application, or move it with the files to somewhere, to another machine, of course. And also, one other thing that it has is that you can click here on Tag Editor, and you have the specific file that I had enabled, or let's say that I can take all these files. You have them here, and then you can edit the. I did three tags that those files have, and set the artist, the title of the each song, the album, and etc. And also, as well, the cover image and the genre, whatever you want. So, from this application, you can completely manage your library of songs that you might have stored in your computer. This application is developed by, let's see here, by Guillaume Boissel. And it is part of a package of applications that you can find on AmiStore. Let me show you where you can find it. If you start AmiStore, there is a package called Z-Tools. Let's give it some time to load. Let me find it. Here it is. Z-Tools. It's commercial. It costs something less than €5, with a lot of other applications in there. There you will find also things that I have here on the, at the dock, at the top of my screen, top right corner, and a lot of other applications. And in there is the iTunes, which you can here this you can download and use it. Quite useful application if you have a collection of music on your computer or on a network NAS computer, like we saw the other time on a previous stream. You might have all your sound files on, I don't know, on your NAS, on your LAN, and you can mount the folder of this network computer that you might have, mount the folder here on your Amiga, and then using the iTunes, list all the files, search for what you need, for what you want to listen to, and start and listen them on with Amiga Amp or any other player. Another application that helps with tagging the music files is Music Tagger. It's also only for AmigaOS 4. And the way that you can use it is select a list of files and put there the title or the, let me show you here, if I go to where I have them, here, my home, for example, here, MP3s, you can see at the bottom the list of the files, and you can set here, change things, and set the ID3 tags and save them into the files. From my experience, it works pretty well, but I prefer the way that iTunes does it. It has more options, and I use iTunes to do that. There is also another application called Qtagger, but we will see this in another time because it uses a framework that has to do with Qt, and I would like to explain in another stream what exactly Qt is and how this is used on AmigaOS 4. Now, Let's see a little bit of available players, except Amiga Amp that we saw so many times here on that stream, and of course the excellent Imp 3 that runs quite well on AmigaOS 4. And this is an application that, let me show you, this is an application that plays mod files from online, right? Downloads the file and you can listen to that. There is also Song Player, also an application that exists for AmigaOS 3 and it's quite old. It supports a lot of formats. You can see them here, MP3, AIFF, IFF8, SVX, and so many others, Wave, and audio files from CDDA, audio CDs. I remember I was using Song Player so much when I had only my Amiga 1200 because that was the only application that you could use to listen to audio CD files through the Pola, because it was transferring all the data instead of having the audio from the back of the CD-ROM, the three pins that you had to connect to a mixer and listen to that. You with a Song Player you could get the audio from the ID cable, and it was transferring that through Pola, and the output was coming from the Pola output. So it was the only player that supported something like that, and I was using that a lot with my CD-ROM on my 1200. And yeah, quite a useful application because you can go and, let me show you, open music here. And you can also remove most of the parts of the window and make it quite small if you want. Very nice application. And recently it was ported to AmigaOS 4 and Morphos. Yeah, helped me remember the old good old times when I was using that on my 1200. Another application that you can use to listen to music is, of course, let me find it, here it is, TuneNet. This is the latest version that is coming with Enhancer 2.1 from Aeon, as you can see here. TuneNet is an application that you can use to listen to MP3 files, SOG files, or audio CDs as well, and also to listen to online radio stations. For example, you can select this one, double click, it adds it here in the list and starts, when it is ready, it starts playing the audio. Let me select something else. Yeah. I stopped the music because we might have issues with the audio, the sound, the songs. So, and you can see some information about the station that you listen to and the songs that they play. Quite useful. And it also has some other features like the skin effects display, which say it changes with the skin totally the way that it looks. Liberal says TuneIt is not that great, many radio channels are just not working with it. TuneIt is getting the information about the radio stations from Shoutcast. I think it plays only MP3 radio stations. I'm not sure if it plays other formats. And that might be the reason why some radio stations are not working. Also, TuneIt is not... there is a free version that you can find, a free old version that you can find online, but it doesn't support, that version doesn't support the online radio stations to be more clear, to search for online radio stations, because it had an old support of Shoutcast servers, and they are not working anymore on the old version. They are working only on the new version. Although that, if I remember correct, there is a hacked version somewhere that you might find that solved that issue, but I'm not sure if that works anymore. The free version supports, if you know the URL of the radio station, you can add it there and listen to the radio station, but you can't search for online radio stations through the free version of TuneIt. Now this one is a paid version, because it's coming with the enhancer package, so you can find it only there. To be honest, Livelord, I don't use that a lot, because I prefer to use Media Vault to find radio stations, and use FF Play or Amiga Amp 3 to play those radio stations. Livelord says, I got mine from Enhancer Packets, if not mistaken. Yes. Not using TuneIt since Media Vault. Thanks for that. Yeah, you see, Media Vault can find all the radio stations that are provided by the online service that I'm using, and no matter if they are MP3 or OGG or AAC format, and FF Play and Amiga Amp support those formats, and you can listen to them quite well on your AmigaOS 4, and of course with Media Vault you get some other features as well, like podcasts, but let's leave it on the side. As you can see, I have multiple versions of Media Vault here installed because of the test that I'm doing. What else? We saw that, and let's crash my Amiga again. As you remember, Hippo Player, the latest versions are working quite well. This is version 2.48. I know a few days ago 2.49 was released. I haven't tested that yet, but I will. Let me find something here. So we have Hippo Player plays pretty well, works quite well on AmigaOS 4. Don't try to use the scopes. From my experience, most, if not all of them, most of them are crashing. So you better avoid it. And yes, whenever we close Hippo Player, crashes, something is crashing. And we have Eagle Player, the latest version 2.06. It works ish. Let me, yes, I have to kill it. let me reboot and show you how it works on AmigaOS 4. Let's say that Inkle Player is not quite system friendly, and it has some issues with timing, and some other parts are crashing big time. But I would like to show you how it works. Hello, Amiga Gamer. Welcome to the stream. Welcome. Today we are visiting some of the audio applications that you can find on AmigaOS 4, working on AmigaOS 4, applications that you can use to create music or listen to music or manipulate your audio files. And that's the topic today. And here right now we had a crash because of the Hippo Player. We all know this very good application for AmigaOS 3, and let's crash again with Inkle Player. Of course, let me point here that that if you want to listen to mod files and many different types of mod files, you can use AmigaAmp. AmigaAmp 3 plays all the mod files quite well, and you can use that to listen to this music. But sometimes we want to remember the old times, right? And we would like to have Inkle Player. I would like to have Inkle Player working. Actually, as you can see, it loads as fine. You can change to the beloved MP skin just fine. And let me load something so you can see how it works, and discuss a little bit about what the actual problem is. Music mods. As you can see, everything here is working quite well, except for the sound. Unfortunately, the Inkle Player has an issue with the timing. If you check, there is a way to change how Inkle Player uses timing through SIA, VBLANK, or timer device. For AmigaOS 4, timer device should be the option to use, but whenever I enable that and try to play a song, my system crashes a lot. And then there is SIA timing that is very slow. The VBLANK timing has to do with the 60 Hz that the VBLANK is on AmigaOS 4, and that's why it from my understanding, it runs the song, the mod file, so fast. You see that it's fast. It's not just me, right? So it's interesting to listen to this beat, but it's problematic. It's not the sound that we would like to have. So yeah, until, I don't know, an updated version of Inkle Player that supports better the timing of VBLANK, or if there is another way. Guys, if you know any other way to make Inkle Player work much better, please tell me. I don't know if Yeah, Liver sounds like Gabber, sort of. Yeah, it's kind of working, but it's not what I would expect from this application and how you can listen to that music. And yeah, let me show you that the same. The same file is much better on Amiga. What else? Yeah, one of the last things that I would like to show you today is a preview that I have of a new application that is on development. It is called Rave. Developer of Rave is Daniel Jendrika, Trixie, who also, if you remember, created the Ad Reaper. Rave is a very nice new application, only for AmigaOS 4 for now. I don't know if he's going to port it to AmigaOS 3, to be honest. It looks quite plain when you start it. This is a preview. This version doesn't support right now to save the sound, the file that you create here, but this is going to be a feature that will be available when the when Rave is released. Daniel Zedlika, as I said, developed this application. And let me show you how it works. When you open the a file, as you can see here, the first thing that you see is that this requester is not the the default requester that you find on AmigaOS 4, right? The default requester is something like that, where you have a list of files. Here, Daniel did so much work and created a different requester because he wanted to have a way to give an easier way to, for the users to find the files. And also, let me show you, if I go to music, I have some files here. When you select a file, you have the ability to see the format and the characteristics of this file. This is something that you can't have with the default requester, file requester with that comes with AmigaOS. And also you have here the assigns, because you might have a specific, multiple specific folders where you have the instruments or whatever you want. And also, as you can see here, there are some assigns that are presented with bold. If you click on them, let me see. Yeah, and if you double click on them, you see the assigns, the multiple assigns for this assign. If you remember, the multiple paths for this assign. If you remember, you can have multiple paths on a specific assign. For example, if I go to C, I have multiple folders assigned to this assign. So you can go, for example, this one and see the files of this specific. Let's go and load something. Music here. Samples. One. And here we have the waveform of that sound. Of course, we can listen to that. It's the same sound file that I used earlier. If you remember, it reminds you the AMI sound editor that we saw earlier, right? But of course, unfortunately, the AMI sound editor is not maintained and it's not in development anymore. So Daniel started creating Rave, You have the ability to open multiple files in different tabs here, and also not only you can cut parts of the sound, there are you can change the level of the file of the sound to maximize or to change the level how powerful the sound is going to be to sound, for example here, right? So you can make it increase the volume or fade in, fade out of the sound like that. And the Rave is developed in a way, in a modular way, where Daniel will be able to add multiple different plugins in the future and enhance the usability of this application. You can swap the channels like that, swap the left and right channel and things, do things like that. And yeah, if he creates more plugins, you are going to have here more effects that you can apply. Of course, you can trim it and listen to that.
Amiga.
And then you are going to be able to save it to another format, to save it in another encoding or even with different sample rate. Yeah, that's one of the new applications that are coming, right? And Daniel is doing a great job on that, and I look forward for this to be released, to be honest. And yeah, that's pretty much what I wanted to show you today. As I said, music is, I'm not a musician, I'm not expert on the topic, but there are a lot of good applications that you can use, and of course someone who is more expert can see if those applications are good for him or not. There are other applications that I never tried that have to do with MIDI music, and of course if you have anything that you would like to propose, please write at the comments and let the others also to know about it. Most of the times I use for audio, I use applications that you can get the waveform of the sound, cut parts of them, because this is also useful when you create podcasts, when you create small videos that you might want to change the sound on something, which also, that's a good topic to see in another time. We can see how you can create videos in with AmigaOS 4, because I don't know if you know that, if you are aware, there are a couple of applications that you can use to manipulate video, and of course it's not going to be 1080p resolution, but it might be also 1080p resolution. It's not going to be like what you do with I don't know, KDE and Live, or with Adobe products, Premiere or something like that, of course. I wish we had applications like that, but we don't. But you can do small interesting things with AmigaOS 4, and yeah, if you get familiar with the applications that you have available, you can do tremendous things. And let me put some music here before we close. So everyone, That's what I wanted to show you today. We saw music applications for the AmigaOS 4, and we saw also at the start, we talked about the APPDIR folder, what it is and how you can use it, which is a very nice feature of AmigaOS 4 in my opinion. And yeah, thank you for being here, for watching, for joining me in my stream. I would like also to thank all my supporters. I would like, as you can, as you know, I have a page on Ko-fi where anyone who would like to support me can do that from there. I have a few very kind supporters, and I have also my Amiga Pals supporters, which is Daniel Zedlika, T. Livelord, and Roban Kargin. And I thank them a lot because they support me for doing the applications that I'm developing, the open source applications that I'm developing. Recently, a week ago, I released a newer version of iGame. I believe you all know about iGame. I released a new version which has some bug fixes, and I rewrote a big part of the code of iGame. And also I developed the Media Vault and other applications as well. And if you would like to support me, you can do it from Ko-fi / Voltero. And just to mention here that 50% every month of the donations are going to other Amiga projects. For November, from all the donations that I gathered from November, I donated the 50% to the developer of Ignition. Ignition is an application that's pretty much like a spreadsheet, which is available for AmigaOS 4. We can see that on another stream, how it works and what you can do with that. There is an older version of Ignition for AmigaOS 3 as well, but I think the development of this version is stopped. But the AmigaOS 4 version, the development continues just fine, and I wanted to support the developer behind it. So have that in mind whenever, if anyone supports me through a Ko-fi page, 50% are going to another Amiga project, and another Amiga developer, or more than one. Usually I donate the money, I split the money to two projects, depending on the amount that is covered. Thank you everyone for being here. Have a great Friday evening. I hope you liked my stream today. It is good that I'm back after the small break that I had for 2 weeks. Have a great evening, Friday evening, and an awesome weekend as well. Livelo says 50% is the best thing ever. I'm glad you are doing Ignition totally deserves it. Yeah, I believe so, Livelo. I believe so. Yeah, I can't. To be honest, there are a lot of developers out there that would like to be supported, of course. And most of the times we might not even know how to support them. For example, for the Ignition, I had to contact the developer to find his email in one of the text files that come with the Ignition and ask him how I can support you, because he didn't have any information anywhere. So yeah, we need to support the developers behind the applications, because those applications make our operating system useful, right? Otherwise, if you have a very powerful hardware, you can't do much if you don't have good applications that you can use, even on a daily basis, right? So yeah, that's the reason why I like to support those developers. Let's see who we can raid right now. I see one of my friends that stream is 300 bytes. She's streaming retro, and let's see. I would say to raid her. So thanks everyone for being here and joining me in my stream, my Friday stream. And as I said, have a good evening and an awesome weekend. Thanks everyone. Bye bye.